frozen feet. Raindrops falling on the street. I can't recall when I last saw the sun. Summer's just a memory, a faded piece of history. No one can remember all the fun. The late night barbecue, zipping on a genie juice.
Hello ladies, welcome to today's video. We are starting in my dump zone, which for me is my kitchen island. So that's the space in my house that tends to get the most clutter. And this particular weekend, the clutter was basically laundry that was washed, folded, but needed to be put away. So I quickly put that upstairs in our bedrooms. And the rest of the stuff you see is basically things we got at Walmart. So anything that needed to go into the fridge goes to the fridge right away, but the rest of the stuff I put on the kitchen island, so now I am tackling that mess and putting everything away. So you see I'm putting a lot of stuff in a laundry basket, and that is because anything extra that we are not currently using is going downstairs to the basement, where I have a shelf, you're gonna see that later on, where I put anything that's, you know, extra stuff. So let me know, what is your dump zone in your house? Is it also a kitchen island, or is it something else? And if you are new here, welcome. My name is Marta. I am a full-time working mom. And on my channel, you're gonna see a lot of organizing, cleaning, routines, basically anything and everything that has to do with home management. And over the summer break, I am really gonna work on my routines, especially for the cleaning, to get into a really good system before the next school year starts for my kids. Because I feel with school year, it provides a lot of structure for the kids, but also it brings a lot of, you know, after school activities, and it's hard to keep up with the house, just housework. So you're gonna see just a lot of videos about that during summertime as I'm trying to figure things out to create better system for myself so things just go much smoother next school year. And this is the pantry I mentioned earlier. It's something that I had created or cleaned up, I should say, and decluttered a few months ago. So I'm going to link that video down below in case you want to see it, because this area in the basement was an absolute disaster. So if you're looking for some decluttering motivation, you can definitely get that there. And clearly it's still a lot of stuff. And as I was putting it away, I probably need to go through a few items to see, because there was just a lot of things from like holidays that, you know, I kept that I got. And I don't know if I actually am going to use it. So that's definitely something I have to do as well. I just wanted to basically do a quick cleanup of the kitchen area, just wipe down the appliances, the countertops, just to, you know, get set up for the weekend and for the week ahead. I don't know if you're the same way, but for me, definitely kitchen is one of those areas in the house where I need to have it clean in order for the whole house to feel cleaner and more put together. So I definitely always try to start with the kitchen to kind of get motivated to clean more and to get that, you know, clean and organized vibe for the entire house. And as I was cleaning up in the kitchen, I finally decided to tackle that little area where we have just by the door with, you know, just keys, you know, and different things we want to grab quickly on the way out. And as you saw, there was just a lot of paperwork that had just accumulated over the past few months. So I just wanted to look through it to see if there is anything that I could get rid of. And I am, as you can see on the left side, I am making a little, or actually when you're looking on the right side, a little pile. That's for my husband to look through to make sure that there is nothing in there that we actually need to keep. But yeah, it's funny how, you know, you have those little areas and you see them. It's taking you sometimes so long to actually tackle it. And that literally took me 3 minutes to go through it. So I don't know why we are like that, but sometimes it just is. Where it just takes you way more time to procrastinate than actually do it. And the next thing that I am doing, which clearly was another day, was setting up a little cabinet from IKEA for my office. So I decided that I wanted to basically create some more storage for scrapbooking things, and it's just different things that go in the office, but scrapbooking was the main one. And the idea was to basically bring all that stuff from the basement. So I have quite a few videos on my basement decluttering, which my basement was an absolute disaster, and I'm not done yet in there, but there I had few boxes in there for scrapbooking stuff. So I used to scrapbook a lot before the kids. Now I have not done it in a while, and I do want to get back to it, but you know, one, obviously time, but two, you know, also when you have things stored in a way that you have to drag a giant box from a different level and bring it and then set everything up, it's not very motivating to even get started. So one, I wanted to, you know, go through the things I had, declutter, and then nicely organize them. And you're gonna see me going through a lot of that stuff later on in the video, and I'll kind of talk to the process I was using. But step number one was setting up that cabinet.
Don't waste my time on yesterday. I never shy away from a good time. Coming on Friday night, I see my friends and feel alright. There ain't no stopping us from having fun. There ain't no cloud in sight. The future is looking bright.
And let me know if setting up furniture is something that you enjoy doing. I do like to do it from time to time. This was not the, well, looking back, you know, once I got started, it was fine. It just took much longer than I have anticipated. And I did end up, I ended up damaging a little bit on the top of the cabinet, not by the setup, but by me thinking that I can lift up this cabinet when I was putting it into my car. I'm sure it's on video somewhere for the security camera for IKEA, but you know how you know when you go to IKEA, you have to, you know, drive up your car to put the furniture in. Well, when I was lifting it up, the shelves shifted in the box, and they literally fell out of the closed box onto the pavement, onto the street. Oh, it was a sight, but it didn't look like I damaged anything until I got home. So there's a little chip on the top of the cabinet, which I already bought some, I think it's called like a wood filler, to fix that. But yeah, I thought it wasn't as heavy when I was lifting it up, but it's just because the weight shifted. I don't know, I'm sure somebody had a good laugh at it when they saw what I was doing, but you know, sometimes you just think you can do things and you really can't. So the original plan was to put this cabinet right here, but I decided to try it out over there because I always need more like space to put like my books and folders when I'm working. So I will try out. I'm gonna put it there, that way I have a place for my planner, and we'll see how that works. So this is the box of all the scrapbooking things that I have. There is another small one that has just basically like the papers in it, but I wanted to go through it and see what I actually wanted to keep, because there was a lot of things in this box that, you know, as you know, on every day, or you know, when I declutter a space in the office, where I will dump things that I think I can use for like, you know, scrapbook or a keepsake, like whether it's a card, like you see a lot of like cards, I think, for the first birthday for our son. So there's just a lot of things that I think I might use later on for that purpose. And as I was going through the box, I did throw away a lot of it because, you know I'm not gonna use it. You know, there's nothing that I'm gonna use from the first birthday cards in anything. So I try to be really strategic about what I'm keeping, and let me know if you are doing scrapbooking or like baby books, because I definitely have stuff for my first child. My second child has basically nothing. It has an empty book. So that is definitely something I want to do for her before I forget everything that has happened during that first year. So I clearly have a lot of pictures, you know, and you're gonna see even some printed ones. And obviously we take a lot of pictures on our phones now, but yeah, it's just with first child, I thought, you know, it seems like I had much more time, and now it's just less and less every year we go through. So let me know if you are the same way. You told me more than once to show you my intention. My brain gets blocked at times, but now somehow I'll give you my attention. You've got to know that I ain't a person who understands all the clockwork of our romance. You make me feel so alive, always there in my mind. But I just don't know if I'll dance with the lights on, if you're gonna be moving on solo. Wait a second, 'cause they're playing the best song. I'll be there if you reach out to me. Reach out to me. And this is the box with all like the paper. So things that I use for the background, to decorate the scrapbook. So I was just going through it. And first I was basically sorting by, you know, what's like a full page that I can use as a full background and any like scrap paper. So I was putting that in two piles. I wanted to color code it, so when I am doing scrapbooking, I can see what colors I'm looking for. And then you're gonna see that I ended up putting all the scrap paper into like a foldable file system. I had one extra when I was organizing my office because I accidentally bought two instead of one. So I thought that was a great usage of that. And the big ones I left in this plastic container, which you're gonna see later on in the video. I decided to actually take it out of it because it would, while it did fit into the cabinet and that the drawer could get closed, it's just I figured when I was opening and closing, it would just be too much of a hassle to kind of take other things out of it to get this plastic container out. So, but yeah, I definitely wanted to, when I was organizing it, I wanted again to be functional. So I wanted it to be easy for me to, you know, when I have time, when I decide to actually start scrapbooking again, to have it easily accessible and not feeling like a chore to even get started. Because that's how it felt for a while, because of that box being down in the basement and being completely disorganized and not making it, I don't know, just thinking about it was kind of giving me anxiety of starting and opening all those boxes and looking for stuff. So I didn't do anything Pinterest perfect by any means. I try to organize as well as best as I can. And then once I actually start scrapbooking again, that's gonna give me more of an idea of how else I can improve that organization to see kind of how the process flows now.
You and me stuck on the ocean now, nothing but waves and they're spilling in. I wanna dry up but you just keep on going, don't you? I don't even know how we got here, all my reasoning have disappeared. I wanna bury the hatchet and find the way back to our home, our home, our home. We don't have to drift inside this dome. I will not let us fade away. It's not a price I wanna pay, and it's not too late. No, we lost our purpose, chasing all that surplus. You were all that I need. I feel that we can break free. We can still go back there to a place with no cares. We can turn this ship around. We can turn this ship around.
So this is that expandable file system that I decided to use, and it worked out perfectly. And this is me trying to fit it into the cabinet, and as you can see, if I put both of them, it is hard to get out either one of them. So that's why I decided to ditch the plastic container. But I still have a lot of space in that cabinet, and like I mentioned, you know, this was actually, the idea was to put it in a closet. But then I decided to leave it there, and it has been there for a while. So a lot of this recording is from a while ago, and it's working perfectly because it gives me more of that surface to spread out as I am working. I spend a lot of time by my desk since I work from home. So between, you know, my full-time job and, you know, my side business and, you know, all the other stuff that comes with just house management and paperwork and all that, it really gives me a good surface space to spread out some of the, you know, if I'm working on a project, to kind of have things around without creating clutter. So it's definitely was a good choice to put it there. And sometimes that's kind of what it happens. You have an idea of how you want to organize and make things more functional. And once you start implementing your idea, you kind of change your mind and rearrange some things to work even better than you had originally intended. And what you can see over here is I'm sorting through like stickers and different decorating things and different things I have saved to use in scrapbooks. So right now I just put it in those plastic, I don't know, folders, files. to kind of by category, whether, you know, stickers in one and different kind of keepsakes in different categories. And it doesn't look very organized by any means, but again, I am not scrapbooking right now, so I kind of put anything that I think I can use. And once I start doing that again, I think I'm gonna have a better idea of how I want it organized and what's gonna work best. But I'm trying to avoid the mistake I did, you know, for many years of getting new stuff to organize with and sorting it when I am not ready for that yet. So I'm not gonna create more clutter with getting things to organize with. I'm kind of gonna wait until I am actually doing that, doing scrapbooking, and figuring it out at that point.
Ourselves didn't have much, but nevertheless we were true to each other. But now we don't even bother. I remember you being hopeful, but the tall waves have worn us down, and slowly we are drowning. That's why you need to come with me.
And that will be it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it gave you some motivation to tackle whatever messy space you have, or just, you know, everyday responsibilities that we have at our homes. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. We lost our purpose, chasing our-